Okay, so 12:30 on the dot. Dianne, thank you so much for joining us today. Hi everyone. Xerxes here with Team Rajpal. We have Dianne with us. Dianne is my trusted agent up north who we work with. We've sent a couple clients her way, and she's helped them buy cottages. So, fun topic today. So, Dianne, can you give the audience a little bit of background about yourself and what you do and where you work?
Absolutely. Thanks for having me. I am based out of Lakefield, Ontario, but we cover the entire Kawarthas, Peterborough County, Haliburton County, and all the way over to Kingston and Frontenac.
Awesome. So, big area, but I know you have a lot of knowledge about the whole place. Now, you work on a team, right? And you and your team help people buy and sell properties.
Absolutely. There's
Awesome.
7 of us on the team.
That's great. Well, I know the feedback I've gotten has been nothing but less than exceptional.
Oh, thank you.
So just wanted to touch base with you, Diane. We've had a lot of people asking us about cottage country. And what are properties doing there? It's a thought that a lot of people have been giving, essentially because of the whole COVID situation. We're seeing two things. Number one, people are not traveling. They want to get out of their city. And the third is that, a lot of people are having this opportunity to start working from home or partially working from home. So they're seriously giving thought to a cottage. Now, with regards to the cottage, sort of market. Can you give us a brief description of what's been going on and how is the cottage market doing?
The cottage market right now is on fire, and for all of the reasons you said, we traditionally have a very strong spring and fall season. COVID has ramped that up drastically, both from the buyer side and the seller side. So the market is moving very, very quickly. We are very low on inventory. We are starting to see multiple offers again. We are starting to see listings holding offers. It is really moving quickly.
All right, so good news for cottage owner. So that's really good. That's very positive. So it seems like there seems to be a huge correlation between what's going on over here and with what's happening up north. Because I know the market over here has been on fire too, but we've been hearing, through the grapevine that up north has been going crazy. So.
It is ridiculous right now.
Okay, well, good. That's good news, right, for certain people.
It is, yes.
And now, with regards to now, you help a lot of people purchase cottages.
I do, yes, I do a lot of buyers.
Excellent. So, are there any tips that you would give people when looking for a cottage?
The first and kind of most important tip I can give is come up with your wish list and then focus on the property itself, not necessarily the cottage, but the piece of land that you're looking to buy.
Okay, so I would like we know, like, I mean, you can't move your lot, right?
Exactly. And you can always fix up the building or the structure that's there, but you cannot change the waterfront. So that's the most important part of the whole puzzle.
Okay, the next thing I wanted to talk about, just to give people an idea, I think people have, because there's such a huge array, right, of the price points there are when it comes to cottage country. So if we let's not talk about waterfront, we will get there in a second. But if what would be a healthy budget you would recommend to me coming up for a really nice property, not necessarily lakefront, but has a decent cottage on it?
So you can still find rural properties that are not on the water for kind of 400 plus. Once you get on the water, the price jumps drastically. We have a lot of places that have deeded access lots, so they're kind of little communities where 6 or 8 or 10 property owners all own one waterfront lot that they can share. That's a little more of an economical way to get into the waterfront market.
Okay, awesome. And with regards to that, I've heard, and I know there's a lot of clients who've been talking about, like, the difference between buying a four-season cottage, do I winterize it, those sort of terms. Could you give us an idea of what that is, number one, and, you know, what's the difference between, you know, full year-round cottage versus just a seasonal cottage?
Absolutely. So the first and foremost is access, whether it is a four-season road, whether the road can be plowed, whether it's a water access only property, so it could be on an island or on a mainland where there is no road. If it's water access only, obviously there's going to be certain seasons that you can't use it. You can't cross the ice to get to it. That doesn't necessarily mean that you can't use your cottage in the winter time. It just means that there's certain times you can't access it. Regarding the actual structure and what is a three season versus a four season, there's kind of three main things you need to worry about. One is a primary heat source. So whether it has baseboards or a forced air furnace or a propane fireplace, those are all considered permanent heat sources. Yeah. If it has a wood stove and that's the only source of heat, that's not considered a permanent heat source. So that's something you'd have to supplement. The next is the water, whether it comes from the well or comes from the lake. We see lots and lots of properties that pull their water from the lake, their drinking water, and then their water for toilets and laundry and all of those things. That is a great way to get water. You can have filter systems, you will never run out, but those lines tend to freeze over the winter. So you have to make sure that that line is heated as well. We do have wells. So if your property is on a well, as long as the well is properly winterized, you can use it for season. The last thing is the sewage. So whether it is a properly placed septic system, if it's a holding tank, there are some factors you have to worry about with that as well. Those are really the main three things. You can always add insulation. You can always, you know, spray foam underneath if needed to make it toasty in there. But those are the three things that banks and most people consider, you know, qualities of a three or a four season cottage.
Right. So a lot about what you just talked about was, you know, the things that include the water. Mm-hmm. And I mentioned before that we would touch on the waterfront. So a typical waterfront property, you know, with that's let's put it this way, quote unquote, turnkey. Mm-hmm. What would something like that cost on, you know, a good lake?
You're realistically for swimmable waterfront, you know, good docking, usable cottage. It may not be fancy, but it's definitely usable as is. You're probably starting at $650 and going up from there. You can still find product underneath $650. You're just going to be making a compromise somewhere.
Right. So that's exactly what I advise my clients in the city as well, right? There's no real difference. I mean, in the sense of like, someone in the city might be looking for different criteria, good school district, it's mm-hmm. close to the highway, close to the GO station, you know, for in cottage country, it's just different criteria that they're
absolutely
looking for. And it typically is location, what your needs and wants are, and your price. And it's those three, I guess, points that have to work in tandem with each other to find the property that you're looking for. Would you agree?
For sure. Absolutely. And you know, we have a saying, they're not making any more waterfront and you can't change the waterfront. So if that is important to you and that is something that you are planning on using quite a bit at the cottage, then that's where the focus should be.
Right. Okay. So the next question I have, because we've been sent questions by certain clients of ours, is where does the opportunity truly lie? Like if I were to come up, because, you know, at the end of the day, it is something that people are looking for partially as an investment. They want to see it grow, right? No one wants to buy a cottage and then see the property value come down. So where is, you know, or where can my dollar take me further? You know, that's another way of looking at this.
So in our location, we have kind of two. We have the Trent system and the lakes and rivers that are associated with the Trent. We also have lakes that are not a part of the Trent, and we call them landlocked lakes. Your dollar definitely goes further off of the Trent system. So if you don't need to or want to be on the Trent, that isn't important to you, your dollar will go further off of the system. The further you get away from the GTA, the further your dollar goes as well. People like to stay in a 2-hour bubble. If you're willing to add 30 minutes to your trip to the cottage, it opens up a whole new world of opportunity and properties. Again, best investment is in the lot. You can always over time fix up the cottage.
Yeah.
You can build the Taj Mahal on a not ideal lot. You're not getting your value back out of it, where yes, the value of the land will continue to increase over time.
Well, and this is what you know, one tries to explain to people, like, the work that you put into your home is the cause of the depreciation of the home.
Exactly.
So, you know, it's the land that goes up in value, right? So once you have that beautiful view and you can't see any other cottages, and you know, you see the water, I guess that no one's taking that away from you.
They are not.
That's good. That's good. Now, I know there's a lot of people who buy cottages, and you know, they can't make it up every weekend, especially during the summer. I mean, when I go up to a cottage, I usually rent one. Mm-hmm. Now, do you find like a lot of people rent them, buy them, and rent them out for not all the whole summer? Like, they're not looking at it purely as an investment property, but you know, there's some aspect to that. Do you find that happens quite often?
Absolutely, and that trend is getting even stronger now. And that's something that has been enhanced through the process we've gone through with COVID as well. Lots of people are looking for a place to escape. Renting it for a few weeks over the summer, or you know, Thanksgiving weekend, or a week over Christmas, or whatever it may be, helps to cover some of the carrying costs that you may not have planned for, and allows you to stretch your budget a little bit further.
Okay, so that's definitely something that people are considering when they're buying their cottage, right? It's part of like the rentability of it, or you know, the future potential rentability of it.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Okay, excellent. And here's the million-dollar question. Where do you see this going? You guys are talking about a hot fire market. And, you know, do you see this continuing? Because, you know, I advise people all the time, don't try and outsmart the market. It usually outsmarts you.
Absolutely. And we're in a bit of a unique situation here. Like, we are a rural and recreational pocket. So they are not making any more waterfront land. They are not making any more acreage. Those things are a limited commodity. The market will continue to chug along. Do I think it's going to continue at the crazy pace it has been for the past 3 months? No, I don't. I do think it's going to balance itself out. Unfortunately, we're in a bit of a situation which is new. We've always been traditionally low on inventory. This year it is ridiculously low on inventory. People that were planning on selling the cottage before COVID hit all of a sudden are not selling their cottage. They have someplace to go. The kids are coming up, the grandkids are coming up. So inventory that would have been able to build isn't there right now. The team I work on, we usually carry somewhere between kind of 30 and 50 listings at any one time. Right now we have 9. So it is historically low. We would need to have a massive influx of inventory to the market to even satisfy kind of half of the demand that's out there right now. Will that happen? Maybe it will. Maybe after this summer, people that were on the fence in the spring will decide to sell their cottage. We don't know. I wish I had a crystal ball. I'd be retired a long time ago. but, you know, we don't see any real indications of it slowing down.
Right. And that's sort of, it's those factors of like supply demand, right?
Absolutely. So,
we always advise our clients, you know, this is don't buy this today to sell tomorrow. You know, especially something like a cottage, you're buying it in the sense of you're putting in money into something that you're going to enjoy over time, and it goes up in value. So that's the way to look at it. First is the enjoyment piece, I guess, right?
Absolutely. And that's what we're finding. People are coming back to grandma and grandpa's cottage. People are living a bit of a simpler life right now. They're not overscheduled. They can work from home. They can come up on a Wednesday and leave on a Monday. You know, it's giving them flexibility and allowing them to kind of take some breaths and enjoy what they have right now.
No, and that's really nice. Well, thank you so much for joining us. If anybody has any questions, please send them over to us. We're happy to put you in touch with Dianne. I'm sure Dianne will take care of you and advise you rightly. She's done it for a lot of our clients. So thank you once again. And if you have any comments, Dianne, please add them now. Otherwise, we'll hopefully be sending some clients your way, and you'll be able to help them find their dream cottage.
Yes. Thank you, Xerxes. No, this has been great. And absolutely let me know if you have any questions.
Thank you very much. Well, thank you, everyone. Happy Friday. and hope you guys have a great, long, safe, and happy weekend. Take care.